In this video, we will study the pathological features of tuberculosis that is classified into primary tuberculosis and secondary tuberculosis. Firstly, let's study primary tuberculosis, and the gross lesions in primary tuberculosis is known as gone complex. Gone complex. Basically, gone complex is a combination of two things. The first thing is a gray-white inflammatory consolidated areas of lungs known as gone focus. And this gone focus is present in the lower parts of upper lobe or upper parts of lower lobe, which means basically at the center of lung. And other than this gone focus, the second element of gone complex is enlarged tuberculous lymph nodes that are present at the hilum of lungs. So what is gone complex? Gone complex is a mixture of gone focus and enlarged hilar lymph nodes. And what is gone focus? Gone focus is a gray-white inflammatory consolidation that is present at the center of lungs in cases of primary tuberculosis. Now here is an additional point that in more chronic cases of tuberculosis, the gone complex undergoes fibrosis and these fibrotic areas undergo calcification. These calcified lesions are known as Ranke complex and they are visible on radiographs. Now for microscopic features, you all know that tuberculosis causes a mixture of both caseating and non-caseating granulomas. Caseating granulomas are those that have a central area of caseous necrosis, and non-caseated granulomas are those that do not have this necrotic center. So here in this diagram is a picture of caseating granuloma. This is a central necrotic area. Surrounding this is a mixture of epithelioid cells and giant cells. Surrounding it is a zone of lymphocytes, and in outermost region there is a ring of fibrosis. Now the second category of tuberculosis is secondary tuberculosis, which occurs in cases of reinfection or reactivation of a latent infection. So basically secondary tuberculosis occurs in one of the three forms. The first one is localized apical tuberculosis, in which there is gray-white consolidation at the apex of lungs. This you know is different from primary TB, where infection causes consolidation nearly at the center or lower poles. But in cases of secondary tuberculosis at localized apical stage, the consolidation occurs at apical regions of the lungs. Now the second form or second stage of secondary tuberculosis is called progressive pulmonary tuberculosis. In this case, the apical areas of consolidation move downward and causes erosion of bronchus. Resultantly, all the infectious materials may enter into the bronchus and get expectorated through sputum. This converts consolidated areas into cavities, and this process is called cavitation. And in addition to the erosion of bronchus, there may be erosions of the blood vessels. So overall, in progressive pulmonary tuberculosis, you see consolidated areas converted into cavitations, or you see erosion of vessels by inflammatory material. The third form or third stage of secondary tuberculosis is called miliary disease, in which tuberculosis disseminate into multiple organs. It can spread to cervical lymph nodes, causing tuberculous lymphadenopathy. It can spread to vertebra, causing Port's disease. And surprisingly, it can move back into the lungs through circulation. And the lesions which will be produced on lung would be small and millet seed sized. This case is known as miliary pulmonary disease. So overall, on gross specimen, there is either apical areas of consolidation or there are areas of cavitation in progressive pulmonary tuberculosis, or there are millet seed sized lesions on lungs called miliary pulmonary disease. At last, on microscopy, if you examine any of these three lesions, the characteristic feature will be same. That is called granulomatous inflammation that we studied in primary tuberculosis. So this concludes the pathological features of tuberculosis.